Hello and welcome back to another tutorial. Today we're taking a look on how to create this winter themed Fortnite design. And if this video gets 1000 likes, I will release the PSD for this. You can also become a member by clicking the join button to get all the project files right away. This video is also made possible thanks to Max and his awesome Cinema 4D Lightroom that I absolutely love. But unfortunately, this is the last time you can buy it, so I strongly suggest that you pick it up and don't forget to use my code EdwardDZN to save 20% off your purchase. I will talk more about the Lightroom and how to use it later on in the video. Alright, so in Photoshop, I'm just going to make a new document. I'm making a Twitter header, so that is 3000 by 1000 and resolution on 72. But if you're making a YouTube banner, I suggest using 2120 by 350, exporting that and then put it in a 21 by 1192 document and then upload that to YouTube. But I'm gonna go with the Twitter header, so just click create. I'm just going to import this image into our document, resize it. I will also have this image linked down below in the description. Just resize it so it fits, kind of like so, looks good. And now we're just going to grab our pen tool and we're just going to remove this sky right here. So I'm just going to fast forward so you don't have to watch that. But if you don't know how to use the pen tool, just make a selection just like so. You can also click and drag to make curves like so, and when you're happy with your selection, just right click, make selection, feather radius at 0 pixels, and it's okay, and then press backspace to delete it. But I'm not going to show that, and here is the cutout version. So just like so. Then I'm going to focus on the background. So for background, I'm using the Visuals 50k pack, just because it has this very very nice like winter background. So just import that to our document. Then I'm also using this image to support our first image, so I'm just going to position it around about right here, and just grab our erase tool and just erase it kind of like so. So then we're going to match the colors, because you see this background here is a little bit lighter than the skin. So then I'm going to go to our adjustment layers right here and select color balance, right click and make the clip mask to our main background right here. I'm going to drag up the reds a little bit, drag up the magenta, and up the blue. We can also decrease the opacity of this color balance layer just a little bit, just like so. Alright, so then I'm just going to add some vignettes to the image. So make a new layer, grab our brush tool, we're going to grab a dark blue, paint around the edges right here. Perfect. We're just going to make this layer the blending mode hard light. Can control U and decrease the saturation just a little bit. You can also grab our erase tool, just erase just a little bit, kind of like so. Then let's focus on our skin layer, so make a new layer above that and right click and make it a clip mask. Go to grab our brush tool, select color white, decrease the brush size and paint in some highlights. That's all around, just like so. We can make this layer the blend mode overlay, just decrease the opacity just a little bit. Perfect. I think I want to make the rock part a little bit more blue. Right now it's kind of looking like a bit purple. So go to adjustment layer, go to color balance again, right click and make a clip mask to our skin layer. We need to drag up the cyan and up the blues as well, but mainly the science. just going to grab our brush tool and the color black selected. Make sure you have the layer mask selected, this white box right here, with the low opacity brushes, brush off the effect a little bit on the skin. Perfect. I'm going to add a little bit more lightning to the rock itself again. So make a new layer under that. That will automatically make a new clip mask to our skin. Up to opacity once again. And add some highlights to the rock. We just laid a bit of overlay. We can erase some of it if it goes on the skin. Just like so. Make a new layer above that. Grab a nice blue color. Kind of like so. Also painting some highlights on the skin. Just like so. We're going to make this layer the blend mode color dodge. Oh, color dodge. And we can decrease the opacity. Kind of like so for now. Now we're going to add our like backlight or the glow effect behind our skin. So make a new layer under the skin. Grab a brush tool. We're going to select a nice light blue color. Kind of like so. And a nice big stroke behind it. Just like so. Make this layer the blend mode screen. Then we can head over to my Wraith pack. Then we're going to explosions and we're going to select this fire effect. Drag it to our document. Press it off the side so we can see it a little bit better. Controlling U, we're going to change the color to a nice blue. Put it behind it. We can also make it duplicate by pressing Alt and dragging with our with the move tool selected. It just gives the glow a little bit more of a texture. Last but not least, we're going to make a new layer with as a clip mask to the skin and have the same nice light blue selected. Make this layer the blend mode hard light. We can use the eraser. Put the eraser to decrease the effect. So just like that. I'm quite happy with that. We can also make one more adjustment layer. This one is going to be a curves layer. It's going to take a point right here. Just drag down just a little bit to add some contrast. And one up here to add some highlight. Perfect. And I think I want to make the background a little bit more intense and blue. So on above our backgrounds, I'm just going to make a new adjustment layer. Make it a photo filter and make it the cooling filter. Let's see, I think cooler filter 82 looks good on density 25%. But as you can see, it's a little bit too intense actually. So we can drag down the opacity till we're happy. I think around 30 or 40% looks good. Also add a little bit of a brightness to the whole image. So make a new adjustment layer over everything. Then I'm going to make a brightness and contrast. Drag up the brightness just a little bit. And we can increase the contrast also just a little bit. Perfect. If you think that's too much, you can also decrease the opacity. Kind of like so. I just changed one thing. I just put the photo filter over everything. I think I want to add some snowflakes to our image to increase the winter feeling. So in my Wraith pack, we can head over to, let's see, particles. I'm going to select this particle effect. Just drag that to our document, put it above everything. As you can see, it's a little bit too small. So just controlling T, we can increase the size and put it about right here. I think looks good. Then we can actually go to filter, blur and motion blur. Oh, I think that's a little bit too much. We can change angle to this angle so it looks like it's falling down, and decrease the distance so we can see that it actually, I think it's a distance of 10 looks good. Make a new layer above it and make the clip mask. Select a nice vibrant blue and just grab our brush tool and just cover the whole image. Going to make this layer the blending mode. Let's see if we find a good one. I think soft light looks good. can see it gives the particles a little bit more of a blue tint and some glow. Perfect. You can also decrease the opacity of this blue layer because snowflakes aren't really blue, are they? Before we add any additional effects, I want to add our text. So for that, I'm using the Max Lightroom in Cinema 4D. So let's hop right into Cinema 4D. Alright, so now we're in Cinema 4D. It might look a little bit confusing, but it's really simple. So just we're presented with this text that I made before, so it's a little bit different from what you see, but just make sure it is on a little bit of an angle, just like this one. And to change the text and font, just double click on it and this section will appear. I'm using a depth of 44 centimeters and subdivisions at 1, and here you can type out what you want and what I wanted to say. I'm making this for face mu, so type out mu just like so and just click and it will change right away. You can also change the font. I'm using Burbank Big Condensed, and for caps it looks something like this. You can just pause and look at my settings if you're wondering. You can also select the material. I like to use this one, the first one, so you can double click on it to change the color. I'm going for a nice kind of blue tint but a little bit desaturated, so you can just play around to get a nice color you like. And when you're happy, you can just click out of this, and if it's not applied, just drag this layer on top of the text and drop it to apply it. When you're happy with your text, click on this save settings or render settings, go to save, and choose where you want to save it on your computer. Make sure the format is on PNG, the alpha channel and the straight channel, as well as 8-bit. 8-bit is selected. Just click out of this and just click this render to pixel viewer to render it out. Boom, just like so. And this takes a couple of seconds if you have a decent computer. And I'm just going to make another text that says face. I'm just going to type that out. I'm going to click on the material to change the color. I'm going for like a nice orange color, kind of like so. And then just go to save settings and change the output, and then render it out. So that's basically it. And if you also want this amazing Lightroom, you can buy it. It is disappearing from the store forever, so this is the last time you can buy it. And make sure you're using my code EdwardDZN20 to save 20% off your purchase. And yeah, let's head back over to Photoshop. I'm just going to import the rendered text. So first we have mu right here, the mu text. I'm going to make it a lot bigger, kind of like so. Just going to position that for now. And then face text, going to make it a bit smaller, put it about right there. And as you can see, it comes out really boring, but the Max Lightroom allows you to change and alter text so much in Photoshop. So I'm going to show you how to do that now. So we can hide the face text for now. First of all, I'm going to start with the photo filter. So go to adjustment layers right here and select photo filter. Oh, make sure it's a clip mask to your text. I think cooling filter 82 looks good. We're going to increase density all the way up. Yeah, what else? Yeah, one more adjustment layer. That's going to be a hue and saturation. We can decrease the saturation a little bit and make the text a little more of a lighter blue, basically. So just like that. We're also going to paint in with some nice light blue on the text, kind of like so. need to make this layer the blending mode. Let's see, to make it the blending mode color dodge and drag down the fill. So difference between opacity and fill. Fill basically reduces the effect of the blending mode, where opacity, yeah, it does what it say. It decreases the opacity, like how much of the effect you see. But the fill change the intensity of the effect, basically. So we're going to decrease the fill to about, let's see, 20% looks good. Perfect. We're also going to make a new layer, make the clip mask. Set our pen tool. We have one point right here and another, and we're going to create a curve like so. Just connect it, right click and select fill path color, which is a nice dark blue color. Click OK, OK again, and it makes a fill. Just like so, we're going to clear it by pressing delete. We're going to make this layer the blending mode, let's see, the blending mode soft light. Then grab our eraser, we're going to erase the effect, kind of like so. Perfect. Can also make a new layer above that, make the clip mask. Try to make the same dark blue as we used before. To grab our brush tool and add some highlights. That doesn't really look like highlight, but if we change the blending mode to either, yeah, color dodge look good. We can decrease the fill, can like so. That looks really nice. I'm also adding another adjustment layer that is exposure. Make the clip mask to text, we can increase the exposure and increase the gamma correction just a little bit. Perfect. Then we're going to select all layers connected to the text. Ctrl and J to duplicate it. Can Ctrl and E to merge it. Going to fill it with this nice dark like cyan color. Just fill it, just like so. We're going to add a motion blur. So go to filter, blur, and motion blur. And increase the distance to about 100 and the angle at 90 degrees. Then we're going to change this layer to the blending mode linear dodge add. But I only want the effect to be shown at the bottom. So we're going to select the text with our polygonal lasso tool. So we're going to select like this part all the way up here. Just like so. To use the basic M shape is selected. You're going to press backspace to delete it. And there you have it, only on the like the 3D part. And we're going to do this with every letter. Just like so, that looks really cool. Oh, and make sure the particles layer is above the text. Perfect. So now I'm just going to add a little bit of a snow layer to the text. So just above it, lasso tool actually. I'm going to first select the nice blue color that we want. Just like so. So I'm going to mimic the shape of like snow that has fallen on the text. So kind of like so. Going to control backspace to fill it in. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And you just don't do this with like every edge of the text. You could do that, but I think it looks a little bit too messy. So I'm going to add a little bit more snow right here. So we can add a little bit more on the E right here. Just like so, it adds to the more to the winter feel of it. What you could do actually is add a little bit of a drop shadow, I think. Oh, not that too much. That's too much. Kind of like so looks good. We can also add a gradient, I think. And like a soft light gradient. We can add a bevel and a boss to that. Yeah, look, that looks really, really cool. So yeah, next up we can actually select all the layers connected to the text. And Ctrl and G to make the group. We're going to duplicate this group, drag it below our main text layer. We're going to make it a lot bigger. Kind of like so. And we are making this the blending mode, I think, if we can find a good one. I think lighter color looks good. Just like so. If you think it's too, we can also erase it a little bit right here. So on the scoop, just click Ctrl E to merge it. Erase it just a little bit right here. And then we can show our face text. Put it about right here. Make a new layer above it and make it a photo filter. Make the clip mask, of course, and make sure it's in like an orange color and drag up the density all the way to 100. Make a new layer over that and make the clip mask as well. Grab a nice orange color, your brush tool, to add some paint just like so. Make this layer the blending mode color dodge, I think. Yeah, color dodge, and then we can decrease the fill. So I think around 50% looks good. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And next up, I'm going to add some winter themed rocket launchers. So I'm just going to find that on Google. I'm going to import that into our document. There will be a link in the description to all the assets I used in this video. So you can find this rocket launcher. I mean, yeah, rocket. What is called? Anyways, I'm going to position it behind the text, just like so. You can make it a little bit bigger, like so. Make a new layer above it and make the clip mask. Grab our brush tool and a white color. Paint in some highlights on it, like so. Make this layer the blend mode overlay. You can make a new layer above it, but don't make it a clip mask. Select a nice light blue color. Paint in. Just like so. Make this layer the blend mode. Let's see if we can find a good one. I think lighten looks good. It blends nice with the background. We can select all these three layers. Ctrl E to duplicate them. Ctrl T, we're going to flip them horizontally and drag them to the other side. Can make them a little bit bigger, I think. So now I want to add some snowballs shooting out of these launchers. So in my wraith pack I have exactly that. So I'm going to see if I can find it, this one right here. Import that into our document. Keep it smaller, kind of like so for now, so we have like something to work with. Make a new layer above it, make it a clip mask. Color white again, or almost this like blue white. Make this layer the blend mode overlay. We can just duplicate it and merge it. Go to filter blur. We're going to add a motion blur to it at the same angle as it's been like thrown, distance at around 50. Go to drag it off to the side a bit above white here, I think. Make this layer the blend mode and let's see what is it. Yeah, I think overlay looks good actually. Okay, not well. Change the blending mode to screen and we can just erase it. So now we have some motion blur going on. And we're going to position this snowball being thrown out of this one. Kind of like an angle, so about right here. We're going to duplicate it and flip it horizontally. We're going to add another one on the right side, but I'm going to make this one a bit smaller. So we have some variation going on. Then it also has to be a little bit closer. Perfect. So now we're pretty much done. I'm just going to add one more effect to put the skin a little bit more in focus. So we're going to add a starburst texture to find one that we like. I think this one will do nice. Just copy it, paste it behind our skin. So right here. And as you can see, it's like cramped. So we're going to drag it up just a bit so. Make sure it fits and the center of the starburst is like behind it. Just like so, looks good. I'm going to make this layer the blending mode. First of all, it's Ctrl and U. I'm going to change the color to a nice blue. Just like so. Make this layer the blending mode. I think soft light looks good. I'm going to use the eraser. Decrease the edges right here. And there we have it. I'm just going to add a little bit of a color correction with a simple snap, just like so. I can't snap my fingers, but wait, there we have it. So when we're happy with our design, we're going to select every layer. Then press Ctrl and G to make a group. We're going to make a duplicate and then merge it. And then go to filter, sharpen, and then sharpen again to increase the quality of it. It looks really nice. And then to export it, go to file, export, and save for web. And I like to save in PNG 24, but if you're worried about the size of it, you can also go to PNG 8. Then just click save and we are done. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you learned something new, and as I mentioned in the beginning, if this video gets 1000 likes, I will release the PSD of this. A huge thank you to Max for helping me out with this video, with this awesome Lightroom. And make sure you buy it, because you can't buy it after New Year's Eve. So buy it before then and use my code EDWARD20 to save 20% off your purchase. So thanks if you do that, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.